into it to see which team will prevail. Of course, we do have the competitive GUI enabled. No flags or names because I don't have the Archon, I'm sorry. But what we do have, if I can get the preview screen on my second monitor, that would be pretty awesome. Yes, I can see now the viewer's prediction. Of course, you can go ahead and vote for your favorite team. Currently, Aguila's ASES team are on the T side. 22% of you guys at home voted for them to be the champions. AS78 did vote for NIP. You can, of course, go vote at fb.me/ESPlanet, and you will see the votes change in real time here on the stream. Of course, if it was a best of three, we'd also have the maps, and that's pretty awesome to have, of course, coded by the lovely producer over at ESPTV. It is Foinks, so thanks to him for doing that. And now we are ready to go live with the match. NIP, their players are Exist, Fifth Lair, and Freiburg, Get Right Forest, and they are, of course, the defending ESWC 2012 champions with a victory over Rare Games last weekend. Casted, of course, by me and Joe Miller. VODs will be up sometime, I'm not quite sure when. They are playing against the awesome Spaniards. It is, as Aguila dies, I was about to say his name. He was a very good player in the match between them and Rare Games at DreamHack Valencia. Their players are Aguila, Ghosty, Torpe, Viss, and Soaker. And right now they are being owned in the pistol round by NIP. So let's see here. We do have one guy at long. We can see that with the X-ray function. I'm not using cheats or anything. That's actually in the game for you guys. You're not sure what that is. But yeah, they will get the bomb down. And if they do that, that would be a pretty good start. But there comes the CT up the ramp right now. Can he get the bomb down? And oh, wow. Couple of frags coming in there from the CTs. And there it is. First round will go to the counter-terrorists of NIP. And of course, now the voting function is not there anymore. So what I said about it being displayed real-time was actually a lie. We will display one at the half, so we can see if you guys have changed your opinions about the game when halftime is reached, and one at the end, so we can see if you guys were right. But right now, we are getting into the game. NIP in the lead, 1-0. As you can see here, the terrorist from Spain currently moving their way into middle. Let's see if we can find Freiburg here. Here he is with that FAMAS of his coming down with one frag. Now the terrorists are rushing here into the B-bomb site. Can they get this bomb now? Can they get it down? The guy down here at the back of the bomb site, bomb is planted very soon. Ghosty with the deagle. Can he pick up a couple of frags? Looking for the first one, but not really finding it. Trying to get those strafe shots. But the flashes are coming in from the terrorist side, counter-terrorist side. With the weapons, of course, it would be terrible for them to lose this round. Coming in here, one frag coming in for the CTs. One coming in for Ghosty as well. Looking at the ground, of course, so they can't see his face. But he is taken out in time. And there's the last one. Killed by Get Right, of course. Legendary Swede survives with 1 HP, but so far pretty good round for ASES. They won an eco, and they got 3 frags, plus they got the bomb planted. And that's a pretty damn good start for them. And now they can't surprise early, but I'm not quite sure if that is a surprise anymore, because, well, mainly everyone does it. But yeah, surely the guys with Masters on the CT side will be surprised. Forest, of course, with the AWP in middle, and Fifth Lair with AWP along. Forrest now coming to help his teammate in B because the terrorists are rushing straight in there. Can he pick up a couple of frags? Freiburg picks up one, and double frag coming in from ASES right now. Looking fairly good for them so far. The CTs do have to retake this one. 3-4. And where is this first man? Okay, Exist right now. The in-game leader is outside of that B bomb site. Currently equipped with a M4, it was, I think. But he's getting flashed, and he has to draw back, and they are saving. So this round is going to go to the terrorists. ASES will be on their first one. And that was actually a great takedown towards that B bomb site. He does throw down that Molo. We'll get a double frag. There we go. And yeah, we'll scare the remaining terrorists off. Of course, late news here. DreamHack Winter has allowed Molotovs. Or actually, they didn't not allow it at any point. We just assumed that they would disallow it, but actually they just came out and said that yeah, Molotovs are going to be in place for DreamHack Winter, so everyone's basically using them in every league now and in every practice clan war, because, well, you have to. They are going to be used at all events, so that's why we saw that coming in. Afri Flan will be challenging here at long. As you can see here, we do have a couple of terrorists outside of long. he's not scared though of that AK fire. Fifth lounge, stay on this ground. Misses the option though, takes some damage, so he'll not get that first frag so early on. They are taking over the middle area now, the CTs, as you can see here. We'll be moving up onto short. I could draw a penis, but I'm not going to do it. Let's see if the CTs can hold it. Looks like they have a pretty good read on what the terrorists are doing right now. Exist and Fiflaren will be ready. Fiflaren actually there long. Let's see if we can find Exist here at the bomb site with that M4. We'll be holding down this incoming push. If it actually comes from now, the flashes and the smokes are coming over. Everyone's flashed on that A bomb site. The terrorists are moving in now. Exist could get a one. There is one from Fiflaren though. Let's see if we can find him. Draws down towards long. And they are getting ready for a retake right now. They are allowing the terrorists to get in on that bomb site. Let's see if we can get it from a bird perspective or whatever you want to call it. We do have the three terrorists here and then a couple of players coming in from long. Fiflaren still at long here. Good flash coming in from Freiberg to flash those guys over on short. He can now move into the bomb site. They have to peek him if they want to kill him while he's defusing the bomb. Forrest comes in with one at long. If Freiberg, he has to pick up this frag. He's actually successful in doing so. And now it's only Soaker remaining. His in CT spawn will be taken out by Freiberg. And that's the second round for NiP. So quite good for them so far. Let's see how the scoreboard looks. We do have Freiberg with 7, Frack a leader currently for NiP. And Get Right with 6. Exist not with a single frag yet. Surely he'll be on there in a couple of rounds. But yeah, of course, no go to the IP for this one, I'm sorry. Usually you can find all just to do a little bit of advertisement for a site that I love. Of course, I work for ES Planet, so I love them as well. But hltv.org is really the place to go to for IPs. If you want to go to a site that has awesome match coverage and all sorts of editorials, go to esplanet.net. But for the IPs and the Dream Team, you really have to go to hltv.org. That site is awesome. So there's a little advertisement in that eco round, which is quite fastly run through. NiP, of course, will win it. Not much to get excited about there. But 4-1 will be the score so far, and yet another buy round for the terrorists. Actually a forced buy round. Torpy only has enough money for a Galil. So let's see here what the terrorist wants to do. We are bringing up the map overview. We do see a split. 2 towards B, 2 towards A, and 1 in the middle. Very, very standard setup. One of them will go towards the lower, while now they are spread out every place. And we do see the smoke here and the smoke here. Double smoke in the middle and one on short as well. From the terrace, flashes coming in as well, so now they will move on to short. Soaker doing some noise. And right now it looks like they will get on short and probably move on to the A-bomb site if it's not a fake. Right now I'm getting flashed, I have no idea why. But yeah, looks like it will be a fake on short, and now they will split into B here from these two angles and get the bomb planted. Let's see here what's going to happen. Jump out of the map overlay. I'm not quite sure how I'm following, but the person is flashed. Here we go. ASES really getting owned here in their attempt to get into this bomb site, but Soaker will come in with a double onto Forrest and Freiberg. Therefore, the bomb will be allowed to get planted for the terrorists if they can hold him back with these flashes. One will be coming in from tunnels, so Soaker has to get in there and get the frag quickly, but he sees him. But a huge action coming in from Soaker. That's his third of the round. Can he take the fourth one? No. Exist comes in with a wonderful M4A1 shot, also known as the Colt. And he takes him out. 5-1 for NiP. And of course, NiP, the recently crowned champions of ESWC 2012 tournament that was... it was quite weird, to be positive. But it had some good matches, that's for sure. And the final was actually quite a good match between Very Games and NiP. But yeah, NiP is still on the throne, proving themselves as the best team in the world. ASES and Be My Frag are probably the two best teams in Spain so far. So best in the world against the best of Spain. So, yeah, lots of good players on the server right now. It looks like they will get the bomb down. That's what matters. And here's an orc picked up by Forrest. Oh, actually, Ghosty was still alive. I totally did not see that, but he will get the frag and the bomb will take away a little bit more. But they do pick up that AUG again, so it was not a fail buy. That's what we can see. Get right, picked it up, probably first, said, hey, get right, get my AUG, I want that back. Because it's a pretty expensive weapon, and it's a pretty good weapon as well. He actually buys a new one. So that's not really that smart. He uses a lot of cash to buy a new one, and okay, they get it's changed around. So I now want to watch Forrest here, because he has picked up that AUG, the AUG, or the AUG, however you want to pronounce it. Not a weapon that a lot of people used in 1.6 and Source. But in Go, the weapons are not entirely locked on the air yet. But yeah, the P90 was very popular in the early parts of the game. The Mac 7 as well. Right now, the Auto Sniper and the AUG are getting some returning fame. Of course, the Get Right used it at the ESWC, the Auto Sniper, and right now Forrest is using the AUG here in the EMS. Here we go. A couple of frags coming in, actually, just two from Forrest. They're spraying through the smoke, and as I watch a guy who's at the complete wrong place. Actually, everyone is right now. The terrorists will get the bomb down. Actually, they don't. The bomb site is clear, but they're not going for it. As you can see right now. Now, of course, the C design on the bomb site, but just in that little window they had, they could have gone in and planted the bomb, and definitely that would have saved them some money, but they decided not to do that. Maybe it was a fake, but it definitely did not work out for ASES here. So, once more, buy round. Three M4s, one AWP, and one AUG for NIP. Of course, AKs for the Ts. Forrest now actually tosses a Molo that does damage to himself. That's not a good way to start a round, so Mifflin will have to even things up with his AWP. Gets the first one through the smoke. That was a beautiful shot onto Torpe there. And where are the terrorists going? Let's see. We do have Soka, B, Aguila, and this coming short. Ghosties waiting outside along, looking to backstab his opponents. Oh, that's Fifflan with yet another frag. I thought Aguila was going to get that one, to be honest, but he didn't. And now he's afraid of doing anything, of course. Aguila, the main star of the ASES team at DreamHack Valencia right now, in the bottom of the scoreboard with two frags and seven deaths. Soka will pick up one. He has actually been playing quite good so far for the ASES lineup. And right now the B-bomb site is clear. Let's see where the CTs are. Oh, they can actually go straight in there and plant. Aguila does have the bomb. He will get in there and get the bomb planted. And I don't think there's much the CTs can do with that. This looks like a round that should be in the hands of the terrorists from Spain. ASES and Fifflin, actually all three members of NIP will be retaking from the middle. Let's see if we can find Aguila here. Here he is, receiving the flashes. Get right coming in with the Molotov. Oh, this is not looking good. Aguila, though, might be the one to save. One, two frags coming in for him. Can he take the third one? The third one is in the gate. Can Aguila clutch this one? 1v1 versus Fifflin with an open hand, 14 HP. I think this one is his to clutch. Let's see. Oh, here it comes. Oh, wow. That was a mix of comes and goes in one word. That's just how I like it. But great clutch by Aguila, picking up the AK. Exchanging three frags and defending the bomb site. And that is one hell of a reason to get excited, because getting a clutch round against NIP is not something you just go ahead and do every day. Now, Fifflin will be AWPing here at long, and there is a terrorist making his way, and Fifflin takes him down. So, back to the map here. I can see what the terrorist wants to do. Want to do, that is. Two CTs at B, or Freiburg just outside of B, guarding the middle area. And that's something that has become very, very popular in the last weeks of Global Offensive. Torpe doing some noise at short, flashing himself, and flashing his opponent there. Actually picks up one, but eventually picked off by Fifflin. That's not really the important thing, I thought. Because I thought the push was going to come exactly when he died or got the first frag. But for some reason, the terrorist has not decided to do that. Fifflin, though, no, that is Get Right. We'll be coming in here from behind. Might be able to pick up one frag onto this terrorist. Out here in the middle, sprays and gets the frag. Gets the headshot. Let's see if Freiburg here can defend this B push here. Aguila takes out one. Freiburg, can he get the double, though? tries his luck and gets the frag onto Soka. Great defense by NiP there. I'm not quite sure if that was the tactic that ASES should have gone for. I think they should have had a guy making noise at short, and then when he got the first frag or he died, they should have ran straight into the B bomb site, because Forest was not going to move. Freiburg was already in the bomb site, so he's not going to move either. So I don't think waiting a lot of time would have saved them anything. They might have the surprise if they've gone straight in. They did have to battle two opponents, but 5 against 2, that's pretty good. But still, that was not the perfect execution from ASES. But right now, Fiflarin is in trouble here in the middle. He picks up his pistol. Can he take the double? No. His teammate comes in to help him, and 9-2. Ho ho. 12, 13, and 12 frags for Get Right Forest and Freiburg. And the producer just sneezed. I'm not quite sure if you could hear that in the background, but it was pretty loud in my headset. Of course, for ASES, 7, 4, 5, 4, and 3 are their frags. Tour-based frags costing a whopping $10,000 in comparison to Get Right, who is quite cheap. 2,800, that is what the cost of his frags are. Of course, that's a new money system stat. A new thing in Global Offensive. Many new things have been coming in the game, and so far it's looking pretty good. Valve always updating each and every week, coming with new updates, listening to the feedback from the community, and implementing it in their game. That's pretty awesome. But here goes Torpe. As we can see here with the X-ray, we do have a couple of terrorists on short, but they are drawing back right now. Let's see if we can find a guy who's at short. No, we can't. They will be pushing back to A, though. Let's see here if the X-ray can get something out of it. Does have a teammate on long. So he will be ready when this push comes in. So here they go. Through the smoke they come. X-ray with one. No. Not getting a single frag. Here he goes. One headshot, two headshots. Torpe coming in with a reply frag onto Get Right. He gets damage from long, and he's taken out as the server lacks a little bit. Freiburg. Oh, wow. The great flashes coming in there. And it will be up to Forrest. Forrest needs to get this frag to the guy long, and if he doesn't, they can't retake. Freiburg, though, will do a great defense right now onto that A bomb side. Oh, double frag coming in through the wall from Freiburg. That's absolutely huge from the Swede. Double frag through from that position, and one of them was through the wall onto the bomb side. He knew exactly where the terrorists were, and he could pick them off with ease. I couldn't even see them when he decided to spray, but obviously that guy has a game sense that is out of this world. So, 10-2. Is the score right now. Of course, in favor of your favorite Swedes. NiP, that is. Well, NiP just secured a new sponsor, BenQ. Get Right Curly tacked up as BenQ. What a nice guy. Everyone is actually tacked up with a sponsor apart from Forrest. Forrest is just so awesome, he doesn't need a sponsor. He just gets paid for just being good as he is. He doesn't need to back up any sponsors. He just doesn't care. But Get Right with 1, 2, 3 frags. Of course, eco frags. So not something to yell about, really. Can he get the fourth? No. Aguila comes in with a deagle. Aguila could actually do some magic here this round. He has a deagle. He's pretty good with that weapon, but right now he's just wasting bullets in the air. And he's taken out by Freiburg. So, 11-2. And NiP looking quite good so far. This is, of course, a match in the ESL Major Series. If I am allowed to guess, it is a bit of a try from the ESL side. Is this game good enough to be on the IEM circuit, the Intel Extreme Masters, which is the biggest league in ESL? EMS, the third biggest. EPS, of course, bigger, but that's national. EMS International. And yeah, I think if the EMS receives a lot of good teams signed up and a lot of good results and a lot of good viewership and a lot of attention, they will be venturing into Global Offensive the next season. Well, that is at least what I'm guessing on. And as a Counter-Strike lover, that would be awesome. I have been missing Counter-Strike at IEMs. I've been to one. That was the last IEM with Counter-Strike on it. the one that ESC Gaming won, and that was such a legendary event. They do know how to host events, those ESL guys. But right now, enough talks about ESL. Now moving into the bomb side, two players from... Oh wow, good headshot from Aguila, of course, from ASES. Bomb is planted now. Aguila and his teammate Ghosty. Can Aguila pick up a second? No, he misses his shot. He has to defend this bomb side now as Ghosty is taken out. He's all alone. 1v3. He has taken out the first one, but oh, he takes out the second one with that AK, but Getride comes in with the headshot, picks up the orc, and yet another round goes to the Swedish star lineup. 12-2. 10 frags, of course, for Aguila. Decided to rack up a couple when I told you guys that he was not doing so well. He decided to say, hey, look at me, I still got it. I'm not at NIP level yet, but I still got it. I can still rack up them frags. Right now, looking like a B push as one of them is taken out. Let's see if we can find Freiberg. He picks up a double. Can he take the third one? Picks up the deagle. Take the headshot. Can he make this ace? Freiberg here with the deagle. Takes out the third one. That was still on that kill feed. But right now, they say CTs are moving into the bomb site. Torpe has picked up an orb. And he's in the... Oh! That was a weird kill to get. He's just running around. Trying to no-scope them. And let's see here the vote. Oh, wow. You guys really like NIP, don't you? Right now, the viewers' prediction, 82% voting for NIP, 18% for ASES. So, of course, go to fb.me/myesplanet to vote for your favorite team. I know a lot of you Spanish/Portuguese talking people are tuned in right now, so go vote for the team that is closest to your home country. Which is actually not close at all if you're from Chile. It's a far, long fucking walk. But yeah, they're speaking almost the same language. So go ahead and vote there. Also give the page a like. It's pretty damn awesome. A lot of news about Counter-Strike Global Offensive, also about StarCraft. But yeah, of course, you can tune that off on the website if you don't like StarCraft. But right now, 13-2 is the score. And yeah, pretty good result here. You see the scoreboard. No 20 bombs, but Freiberg and Getride both with 18 frags. And now, just to be a bit of a dick, I'm going to say, if NIP wins this first pistol round, they will win the game 16-2. Because, if you're not familiar with this money system in Counter-Strike, if you win that first pistol round, you almost every time get the next two as well. And if they get the next two, they will be on 16 rounds, and 16 rounds ensure a win. So right now, very important round for ASES. Not ASUS, but ASES. Just for those of you who are currently not knowing what I'm talking about. A bomb is planted though, for the terrorist of NIP. This looks very good. If there's a team that's good at defending, it's NIP. They're good at attacking as well, but they are especially good at defending right now. The CTs are making their way in. Forest is the only one remaining. I'm sure he's going to do something, but it's going to be extremely hard for him to do anything. 4 HP. We'll pick up one frag. Picks up a second one, actually. But 4 HP remaining. No way he's going to clutch this one. But he shoots. He does shoot for that bomb defuser, but not hitting him. Taking a double, but not enough to win the round. So, pistol round will go to ASES. And that's a pretty good start for them. They needed that round, and they got it. Right now, I think the scoreline will be 13-5 before NIP can do something, really. Right now they're on a complete eco. Just waiting in spawn, chilling out. Oh! Forest buying an AK. That's a tactic we've seen a lot of times. One AK being bought. If the player has a lot of money. Actually, everyone has bought something. They bought a lot of grenades. They're thinking that, hey, we want to end this early, and if we don't win it, it's not really a problem. We're going to end this early, so we're going to take a chance here. But of course, they do have a lot of rounds in the bank, so they can't afford to lose and take risks like these. So let's see here where they want to go. Freiberg is taken out. It looks like a B push right now. Everyone's flashed going into this B bomb site from the tunnels. Here comes Fifflaren with that P250. And if you have been watching this channel a lot lately, you will know that Fifflaren is good with it, but not right now. He's taken down to 12 HP. Forrest still with 100. And if you know Forrest, an AK in hand and 100 HP remaining, or 99 for that case, everything can happen. That man is a maniac. A CS maniac. He can make something of every situation. Right now he has to make good plays and not really going to here. Exist though. 15 HP. Sees one opponent, but does not have the bomb, so yeah. He has to do something with these remaining 15 seconds, and he's going to do something. He's going to die. Not the best of situations, but still. 13-4. Maybe NiP just thinking, nah, we want to give you guys an interesting game. And the producer is smiling, so I'm guessing some of you wrote something funny in chat. Please keep him smiling. He's very bored, usually, in our streams, because he has nothing to do. He's just sitting there, doing nothing. Actually now, with the new function, he's actually going to do something, adding the map score. Which is not that hard at all. I'm just hassling him. But let's see here. Eco push out of middle. Piclan will get one, actually. But not really doing much. So, 13-5. Of course, with that buy in the second round, they used a lot of their money. So, it's now first here in the fourth round they can buy actual weapons. Very important round. Actually, all rounds from now on actually important for ASES, because they can't lose anymore, to be honest. Of course, they can get it to 14, but then they have to win the rest to win the game, or else it will be a draw. I'm actually, yeah, this is group stage play, so draws are actually what's going to happen if it's 15-15. Let's see here, we've fight Forrest here, in the middle, going out here. Taken out by Soaker. Now moving into this bomb site, Get Right with his teammates. There is one here at car, but taken out by Get Right. Smoke coming in, bomb doing exact same. So 3 versus 3, post plant scenario. NiP should have this one in the bag, but as you can see, this does have that Molotov. I'm not quite sure how he's going to use it, but he can utilize it. Flash is coming in here. The flan going for the frag. I'm not sure that is the smartest choice, but he's not dead yet, so it's pretty good. Flag does see one. Exist with one. Get Right with a double. Get Right with a second one. And Exist with the final one. So, NiP on 14 rounds. 5 in favor of ASES. Aguila will now be picking up the AWP when all his teammates. Okay, they are buying now. That would be quite weird. Picking up an orb while all your teammates are currently with pistols. See if Aguila can show us some magic. Okay, he sees one. He misses, sadly. So something's sure happening at B. He gets that information from his teammate, and now the bomb's gonna get planted. Aquila knows this, and he's throwing an aid down there. Bomb has been planted. And they are drawing away. So I'm not quite sure about this tactic, because that means they're playing for the draw. This is the weirdest thing I have ever seen. They are playing straight for the draw right now. The ASES team. They are all hiding at the long. Look at this. They are behind. They only have 5 rounds. Their opponents have 14. It will be match point for NiP if they win this one. And they will. 15-5. And something is wrong. Here we go. So 15-5, deciding to save that round. Now, the players from ASES have to win 10 rounds in a row to get us to a draw. They are playing for 1 point right now. 1 point. And I'm not sure they're going to get it, to be honest, because NiP are just too strong right now. Let's see here. This, with that Molotov grenade. Of course, we are playing with Molotovs allowed. It's just going to spray through the wall. Fiflan receiving the flashbang. Forrest outside along, picking up Torpe. But if a clown will get one, but eventually dying. So now, Forrest, 1v3 to win the game and secure 3 points for NiP. He has 100 HP, a couple of flashbangs, a smoke, and a grenade. So it is completely possible. Oh, he sees the position of that grenade and therefore knows where one of the CTs are. Now waiting for the grenade to come in. And, yeah, he needs at least one. Okay, he actually decides to go straight through the smoke because he knows the position of one of them, but not going to happen. This takes him out with the headshot. And 15-6, still match point for NIP. So, will the Spanish team take us to draw? Or will the Swedes end the game? Right now, Aguila, as I'm talking and babbling away, he actually takes the first rack onto Freiburg with the orb. That was a pretty good start for them, and I totally missed it. My bad. Get right, picking up their auto-sniper. He's pretty known for that. He's pretty known for picking up unusual weapons. He can go. That's, yeah, he's been quite good with those weapons, but so far, not racking up a single frag yet with it. This is, of course, the first round, and Torpe taking him out with a single one. So right now, 5 against 3. Forrest, of course, with the orb. So could do potentially a lot of damage. As you can see here with the X-ray, not many CTs are laying around. Here is Aguila. I just saw him here. Aguila, that's what he's called. I don't care if he's called Aguila. In my world, he's Aguila. The beast from the east. Actually, not from the east, from the south. What's a good word? What's a good name for him? The slaughter from the south. Aguila. With a G, that sounds weird. Let's see if he can pick someone up. Right now, you can see here the positions of the T's. He's not quite picking up a frag just yet. See here, Aguila, can he come in here with that AWP? Oh, picks up Forrest, that's huge! And right now, only for Flower remaining, and he will surely stay away. So, Aguila picking up a round for his team. I'm not quite sure if it's just the producer trolling me, or if it actually is the Spanish guys in the chat saying that I'm pronouncing it wrongly. Well, that's just how it is. Of course, I'm not fluent in Spanish, so I have actually no idea how to pronounce his name. I'm just... Usually when you commentate in English, you just Americanize or something. Americanize the names so people will all understand it. Of course, if I started to read out the Danish players' names in Danish, everyone would be like, what the fuck is going on? So right now, I'm just trying to make it understandable for everyone. But yeah, 15-7 still. A couple of players low from ASES. Soka picking up yet another one. And this with another frag. Of course, Soka and this probably also pronounced in a different way. Just guessing. Torpe also with one. And now it's only Forrest remaining. But that was, of course, an Eagle Eco from NIP. So they didn't expect to win that one. But right now, 15-8. The comeback is on. It can still happen. It's 6-2 in the second half. And, yeah. Can still happen, of course. They are not shy, these ASES guys. They're not just giving up. They are true soldiers of Counter-Strike. They know that they can always win the battle as long as the opponents have not got 16 rounds yet. It ain't over till the fat lady sings. That was a quote that Joe Miller used a lot in the last weekend, so that's probably very fitting. Right now, Ghosty being flashed a bit here, I'm sure, but works together beautifully with his teammate. Let's see if we can find Anguilla, the one and only. But he's not really finding anyone. Ghosty with one here in the middle. He might be able to catch a few other ones transferring towards that short area. Brian Flash coming over in the middle. Let's see here. We have Torpe out long and Ghosty here in the middle. Aguila looking for a couple, but not really finding them. This also coming in here into the middle area. And looks like yet another round for ASES. It's actually pretty good for them so far. 15-9. 15-9 in general would just be a great assault against NIP. Not many teams are able to get 9 rounds against them. But for Flan so far, 1v3 to win the game. Fifaladen, Kasha Shade, Swedish. But he's taken down by Aguila or Aguila. I'm not quite sure if that is. I think that is the correct pronunciation. Aguila. With some rolling letters on it as well, because that's the Spanish language. Actually, I only know French and then the Nordic language and English, so not really fluent in other ones than that. And a bit of German, of course. Because we love Germany here in Denmark. They supply us with cheap beer. Another guy who is very important in my life right now, and it's Aguila. He picks up the third one. Great play for him so far. Soka coming in with that last one, and four-man from Aguila. Oh, wow, great round from him. Great defense, and that could be a very, very important round for them. Because right now, they're only five rounds away from actually drawing this match. And what a result that would be for ASES. What a start to the EMS adventure that would be. If they could start out with a draw against the best team in the world, that would surely strike fear into their their other group teams' hearts. If they could get a draw against NiP, because if you go into a group stage with NiP, you always calculate to lose against them. But if there's a team that suddenly draws NiP, you get a bit scared of them as well, because that means they should be equally good. Of course, no offense, but they aren't. Not yet. But drawing against them is a great result to begin with. No team is as good as NiP. Maybe they are. I'm just not. I haven't just seen it yet. That's probably the reason. Well, let's see here. NiP going onto the bomb site. Flashes coming in from the CTs. I'm not sure if Frack has been exchanged yet. No, it hasn't. Five players still alive for both teams. NiP Freiberg looking for the guy in the pit. But he's not really showing himself. Bomb will go down. Aquila with a one. See if we can find him. The favorite player of everyone here. Everyone in the world actually loves this guy. He is the Nesty of Counter-Strike. When he comes into a server, people disconnect automatically. Right now, Aquila here with AWP looking for that frag. Onto that guy behind Gandalf. I'm not quite sure of any other countries called Gandalf, but in Denmark we call it Gandalf, but that does not matter. Exist and Freiberg now remaining. Only Exist now. Can he hold this bomb down? It is still taken away, but it is going to be defused by Ghosty. And even though Exist there will get the last two frags, that's not going to matter. It's going to be 11 to 15. And Aguila's team is still not dead yet. They are alive and kicking so very much into the scrotum of NiP, removing their balls from the ball sack, putting it in their stomachs. That was probably the weirdest sentence I've ever said. It's just to clarify how sick of a nutcracker that kick from ASES right now is. They are really doing a great job of defending against NiP. And this guy is one of the reasons why they are doing so great. He is at 22 frags right now. Such a great game for him. And the last time I casted a game with this guy, Aguila, he was also a beast. And this guy's just insane. There's no matching him. And when even freaking NiP can match him, you know it's serious. It's pretty damn serious. Right now, NiP a bit stagnated. Freiberg will come in here and take down Aguila. Soka with the double though to even things out in the favor of the CTs. But right now, Freiberg doing a great deal of job. Great deal of job. That's not a sentence, Risk. Get it together. Exist though. It's a man who has it together right now. The bomb is on his back. I'm not sure the CTs have heard him yet. Oh, there is one outside of B, so yeah, they will hear him. He's taken out by Torpe. So, ladies and gentlemen, 15 to 12. The scoreboard says it as well, so it can't be wrong. ASES Club, their full name, are on a comeback against NiP. I know how crazy that sounds, but look at the scoreboard. Look at it. It says 2 to 13 in the first half, but now 10 to 2 in the second one. They saved in a round that got the 15 round for NiP, and they are still in it. I have no idea how, but somehow, some way, ASES are still in this match, and huge props to them for that. This is a great result. Even if they lose the round now, this is a great result, but I think they want more. They can taste the draw right now. I'm not sure how a draw tastes this. But this draw must taste pretty good. A bit like pie, maybe. all be here. On short. Drawing away. That's actually quite a clever thing to do. To go into long when you know short is being taken over. Because, you know what? Look at this. Look at the X-ray. What a great game sense from Torbay. Oh, he turns his back. That's not great game sense at all. Now we have to focus on the Ghosty here on long because he has a hell of a big job right now. We have the X-ray enabled. Soka picking up one. They have to watch short as well. There's a terrorist there, but he's taken out by Viz. As Soka is taken out yet another one, and Ghosty with a frag onto Fivlaren. And 15 to 13. Jesus Christ, what a game! Wow! The VOD of this one will get 1,000 million gazillion hits on YouTube. I'm very sure of that. Just to quickly do a very, very unbiased, very bad transition into saying that our VODs will be available at youtube.com/myesplanet. There you can find the VODs for all our games and all our upcoming talk shows. There is actually one upcoming very soon. I'll tell you about that when the game is over. But yeah, youtube.com/myesplanet. Right now, get right securing one frag. The CTs are holding down this A bomb site. As you can see here, one CT at short. Or one terrorist at short. That means the push is coming onto this B bomb site. But Viz is doing a great job of holding it down. Let's see where they are going right now. A great Molotov comes in to separate them from each other. Viz can come in here through the smoke, but he decides not to. Very careful play from the CT player. Of course, they have only one round. Or the terrorist only need one round to win the game. So they have to play carefully. Let's see here. Torpey can see them here lower, but he just gets a glimpse and then goes away, straight away. Right now they are situated here in upper, get right in the middle, and Viz could do a huge amount of damage in his position. I'm not sure if they know he's there. See here, yep, huge headshot coming out of Viz. Oh, the second one! Great pre-fire from Viz, and that could secure the 14th round. Only get right remaining, 1v3 to win the match. If not, it's going to be 14 to 15. Can get right clutch this one. Galil in hand. He has secured the first one. Picks up the AK, I think. That what is... another girl. And another girl. So loads of Galil's here in the middle. Can get right clutch this one. He has to do it, or not has to, because they are on 15. But this means that one round away from draw. NIP need to get this round if they want to get 3 points out of this. If not, it's going to be a draw. And what a sick scenario this has been. Look at the second half score. 12-2. 12-2 against NIP.
I'm just... Oh, wow.
This is so great. Because NIP just been crowned as champions of ESWC. And now just probably their first match after that tournament. They are being challenged by a rather unknown team. Not to say that they are completely unknown. People know them. They are a great team, but they were not at the ESWC, unfortunately. And yeah. Let's see here. The terrorists. Where are they going? They are rotating currently. We're going towards B, but now going towards long. Let's see if we can find that one who was at long. It was Torpey. Molotov is at long house. Not really happening anything so far. Two players on short. Flash is coming in. It looks like a split A. Torpey has to do a great amount of work here along to hold this one down. He goes for the spray, but Fivlaren takes him down. Viz now at the bombsite. Great headshot coming out of Viz. If they can hold short, that's a good start for them. But right now, Exist is doing great work. And also a guy at short is doing great work. Huge headshot coming in at Viz. If he can get one more, that would be phenomenal because Aguila has to come in from behind. He has to get from long. Aguila picks up one. Aguila now 1v1 to draw this game with a Deagle hand bomb. It's going to be bloody. He draws it. Oh my God. Aguila, the huge hero, the slaughter from the south, from ASES. And look at that vote. 13% of you believed in those guys. 13%. They freaking drew the game against Very Games. And if we could get a camera on my face. Oh, not Very Games. That was last time. NIP. Wow. What a phenomenal game.